Ephesians 6:10-11. Be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to withstand against the schemes of the devil. Yikes! I better put on my armor.
Hey, you want to join us for a study hall? We're going to go study in the class.
Whoa, stand back. I'll protect you from any cheating, plagiarizing.
What?
Yeah, but back up, Meg.
Don't be tempted.
Don't be tempted.
You know it, girl. We're going to have so much fun. Okay, I see you. Oh, wow. Hey, Whit. Hey, you want to come eat lunch with us? We're planning a party.
Look out.
Whoa.
Yes.
Okay, what's up?
Stand down.
Okay.
I'll protect you from gossip and slander. I see you ladies over there.
What?
Gossip and slander.
Wait, what?
But quiet. Shh. It could attack at any moment.
Huh?
I won't let you go down like this, Meg. No way.
Ooh. Okay. Come on.
Okay. Oh, yeah, ladies. I see you.
Okay. Gossip. Hey, Whit. Hey, are you going to the game tonight or what?
Oh,
what's
yeah.
up? Are we going to play?
You bet I am.
Whoa. What?
I'm going. Yep.
What is
Don't
this?
You worry, Meg. I won't let you lose your temper or get angry. Protect you from yourself.
Why would I do that?
I got you, Meg. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Yes.
Hey, you know what? Let's bring this down. Let's stop this. What's all this armor thing? Why are you trying to protect me?
You're defenseless. But don't you worry. I have got the armor of God on. I can protect us both, just like Paul tells us in the book of Ephesians.
Oh, okay, Whit. I gotcha. Oh, yeah. You know what? Actually, I think you got this whole armor of God thing all wrong.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, Paul did talk about protecting ourselves, but not with, like, actual pieces of armor.
You mean I don't need this sword?
Yeah, well, I mean, actually, you do, but you actually need the sword of the Spirit. Here, read here in Ephesians 6:12.
For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers over this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Wait, so we aren't fighting a physical battle, but a spiritual one.
Exactly. Oh. Exactly. And see, just like Paul explains, like a Roman soldier would have to arm himself for battle, we too have to arm our hearts and our minds from the enemy attacking. God's armor is the most powerful way to protect ourselves.
How do I get this armor? Do I ask for it?
Yeah.
Oh.
You actually pray and ask God to give you the armor you need so that you can just put it on every day and fight off the lies and schemes of the devil. God told us through Paul that we should pray at all times and keep alert and persevere so that we can boldly share the gospel.
Wow. So I guess I really don't need this armor anymore.
Yeah. Yeah, but thanks for protecting me. It's really nice. Hey, you know, we could use this armor in the game tonight. Scare off our opponent.
Yeah.
Let's
do it. Bible, and that's a wrap.
Wow.